There's been a huge change in federal regulations that can make your life a lot easier if you're an instrument-rated pilot. The regs say you have to fly at least 6 approaches and fly a hold within 6 months to stay current.
But for many of us GA pilots, that's hard to do, as you know, Melissa. We just don't fly enough in instrument conditions to stay current. So we have to go up with a safety pilot or an instructor to get the required approaches under the hood or do a full-blown instrument proficiency check. Until now.
So the Part 61 rule change that came into effect last week now allows pilots to use a device like an ATD to maintain their instrument currency in just the same way that they would have previously done it in an aircraft.
It's right there in FAR 61.57. 6 instrument approaches, holding procedures, and course intercept and tracking logged in instrument conditions within the preceding 6 months in order to fly with passengers in IMC. Trouble is, staying current is hard because most of us fly, most of the time, in visual conditions. But now you can get current using an FAA-approved flight training device or aviation training device.
You can now, you know, fly times when you wouldn't be able to fly outside. If you had icing conditions or other forms of bad weather, you can still maintain your proficiency without, you know, burning your av gas.
And you can do it on your own.
Yeah, and you don't need an authorized instructor available to sign off on this training session in the ATD for these currency activities. That was another part of the Part 61 rule change that went into effect in July.
And you have a year to regain your IFR recent experience in a training device.
That's right, 1 year. Yes, I know, most of you read the regs and say, hey, it's 6 months. Not really when you look at it. You get current and you're good for 6 months. Your currency expires, you still have another 6 months to get current again using the ATD or a combination of aircraft and ATD. It's only after you've been out of it for more than a year that you need to get the IPC. Trust me, the folks in the Pilot Information Center have been over and over this. They've talked to the FAA. That's the way it is.
So you can use an advanced training device like this Redbird FMX, but some of the desktop trainers have also been approved. Just check for the letter of authorization for the particular device.
So logging these activities, they go in your logbook almost like any other flight. You want to make sure that you're accurately logging the make and model of the device you're using. And you'll be able to find that on the letter of authorization for the device. If you really want to be specific, you can also log the serial number of the device. Otherwise, it gets logged as you know your approaches and holding, intercepting, and tracking activities, whatever you did.
And if you do use the sim to get current, make it a workout.
So if you're looking to maintain your instrument currency in something like an FMX or another ATD, it is a good platform to practice things that you may not be able to do while you're out flying your aircraft, perhaps on your own. So things like electronics familiarization or a partial panel precision approach, practicing those would be good activities to do in an ATD to maintain currency.
So, you know, Melissa, I think, again, for me as an instrument pilot, this is really a huge deal, and it makes so much sense. And it's something that you folks in the advocacy have been working on for quite a while.
It is. We'll take some credit for it. I mean, it's a group effort, but anything to make it easier to stay current, and it makes sense.
It does. So. It makes sense, and it makes us safer pilots.
We'll keep looking for opportunities like that in the future.